Hey guys, Pasty Boy here. Today we're going to pick up a newer sled for Mark, my brother. So you guys been asking for it. Hopefully this sled is as nice as we hope it is. And Gary's coming and we're going to be leaving in a few minutes. So stick around. All right, so here we are, me, brother Mark, Gary. We're on our way to Buffalo, pick up a sled. We won't tell you about it just yet until we get there. And hopefully we're good. I don't think all three of us would be going if we weren't getting this thing. I think it's gonna be good. Gary knows the guy. So we'll be right back.
Everybody got money?
Yeah.
Because I don't.
A lot of money, man. Right pocket, Gary's got some in his left pocket.
All mine that I don't hold on to.
That's right.
See you in a bit.
That's the way you don't spend it. We're here. There's the sled. I forgot to grab the camera since we got here. But 03 Blair Morgan, never had a beaver tail. 800 full Dynaport exhaust and can. So those numbers aren't going to be valid anymore.
No, the guy signed them anymore, right?
Yeah.
You still have it?
Yeah. He does.
You get good luck with it?
He put a fucking dime in there.
How many years ago was that?
A long time.
Right? Was it 5 years
ago? So you're not going to be able to see the gauges sitting down.
Yeah. The other thing
I could never see my gauges on my old sled either.
The temp gauge, I was telling him, they superseded the part number. You might be able to get a GSX thermostat, and that gauge will work.
Okay.
It doesn't right now. Never had any heating troubles with this sled. The gas gauge, quarter tank off, always. Okay. Always.
So it'll show a quarter, but it's empty?
It'll show three quarters when it's full.
Oh, okay.
When it gets to empty,
still got
you got a quarter.
Okay, gotcha.
So I always base it on about 100 miles.
Yeah, that's
or if you're by a gas station, top it off.
Yeah.
Top it off. I don't know if you, I don't know what the fuck happened to this bag.
So this is the Blair Morgan 800 Super B.
Yeah, I don't know if my trailer might be leaking, but
yeah.
Bag and then here, take all these fucking belts. You're not gonna need. So you got five belts.
Wow.
You won't have to buy a belt for a while. What else? Manual. There's the shorter ground wire.
So I just need a thermostat? You know which one to get, Bob?
No, you don't need it.
You don't need a thermostat.
No?
No, you don't need one. If you need your, if
it's
you
only
want.
If you wanted the temp gauge.
Yeah, if you want that gauge want to work, work. It'll still, idiot light will still come on
okay.
If it overheats.
Oh, okay. All right. That's
but I've never had a problem because in 03, they, 03 and a half, they made the coolers longer.
Yeah.
Where the old threes, if you put the beaver tail delete on, you had a shorter cooler.
Right.
They'd overheat. That's your old butt.
Is it really?
Mm-hmm. So it's got a Cudney clutch kit in it. It's geared for top speed. I went up one tooth. The gold digger studs and the dyno port.
Studded.
Yeah.
No more sliding.
No.
It's had a nice track.
So beat him and I'll be able to keep up with him?
No, you ain't keeping up with him.
No.
No.
Alright, Bob, we need to rebuild this Fargan thing.
It goes.
I'm sure it does.
It does.
I mean, I got a 700 now, which moves. It's got to be a little bit faster.
It goes. When we were in Old Forge last year, my buddy Sean had to ride this and he tried to race me.
Well, his is 16. Or 600. 700, I was keeping up five. But it'll be.
All right, you gotta pull that pin. Trailer's filthy, you gotta wash it again. It's been sitting under my brother's tree at his house. There she is. This thing's picked too. A studded track. All right, so I'll go step on the other side, I guess. Where'd they go? Should be fine, it ain't going nowhere. Just don't hit the bracket there. Get off and tilt it up, I guess. Put the pin in and then we'll tie it down. So apparently this, even though it's an 03, it's really an 03 and a half spring order Blair Morgan, no beaver tail ever. 800. I like it, looks good. Pretty cool looking sled.
Is everybody happy now?
I know. So what do you think? Are you psyched or what?
Yeah, it's a newer sled.
Hell yeah.
I'm in the right chassis.
Exactly. Revolutionary. Perfect, right there. Got V-Force 3 reeds in it. Freaking Moto. It's a Scenari.
Gotta go over.
You gotta move it over?
Yeah.
Right. Just make sure you leave enough room on that side for the thing to shut. For the cover to shut, that's all. Let me take a look. Should be all right. Yeah. Perfect. Yeah, it's perfect. Awesome. I really like those handles.
What's that?
On the tie downs, because they swivel. Instead of being just like a straight up bar,
they
this is like a. Yeah. It's got, you know. It swivels, you know, or whatever you call it. Like a... Yeah, put the brake on too. You're good.
All right, so I gotta charge the battery. You got a battery charger?
Yeah, I do.
Because I don't have one, believe it or not. All the crap I have, I don't have a battery charger.
Huh. All right, well, maybe when we get back to my house or whatever, we'll take the battery off. All right, just about to leave. Got the sled. What do you think, Mark?
It's a sled that's newer than mine.
That's right. How about you, Gear? What do you think of the sled?
I think it's in really good shape. Looks nice.
Yeah. Awesome. Nice. All right. So we did it. He's into the new Rider Forward. And we'll see you later. All right, guys. Well, we made it all the way out there to some suburb of Buffalo, as you could see. Bought the sled. Mark's psyched. We're all psyched that he's got something newer, Rider Forward. It's an 800. It's going to be fast as hell. And it's got a full Dynaport exhaust on it from the pipes all the way to the can. And guy was real nice, threw in a tunnel bag. So we're looking forward to the first ride. So if you like the video, please give it a thumbs up. We'll make a review on it later when we get time. But right now, things are real busy. Tomorrow, don't know when This is going to get uploaded. I'm going to try to upload it right away, but I'm going back to Cooper's, bringing my sled in. I'm going to have the whole thing gone through, pre-season check, greased, everything. He does everything to the sled that it needs, clutches, belt, adjustments, all that kind of stuff. And I'm putting on the adjustable riser that I bought, and we'll see if there might even be something else in the future, but I'm doing that tomorrow morning. So right now I'm going to get back to a video that probably will be uploaded after this, talking about ram mounts. A lot of stuff on the sled, so stick around. Like I said, please give the video a thumbs up if you liked it. Check the links in the description. There's stuff down there you might be interested in. Subscribe if you like the videos that I'm putting out there. And I want to thank every single subscriber I got. If you comment on the videos, you know me, I answer you back. We're just as passionate about snowmobiling, you know. So we love it, and we love the comments. So just, you know, give it a thumbs up, drop a comment, and we'll see you next time. Take care.